Welcome to the ISSF World Cup Shotgun 2022. Final will start in 10 minutes.
Welcome you in this lovely spring day at the beautiful shooting range of Ponte Verde for this final skate man.
Sun is out. The wind has disappeared. Clayton is on the prowl. Can only mean one thing. We're about to get underway with the Skeet men's competition here from the Trapconcaverde, Veneto del Garda, northern Italy, not far from Lake Garda, as the name I guess would suggest. It's a fabulous venue. The stands are full, and why wouldn't they be when we have a really, really strong eight made it through to the final stages after qualification. Gabriele Rossetti, the Olympic gold medalist in Rio, taking the Italian hopes. Not just him, Stefanos Nicolaidis, you just saw of Cyprus. This is Elia Struscioli of Italy, the 23-year-old. World Cup gold in Nicosia earlier this year. Nicolas Lejeune of France, the 23-year-old, and certainly a real prospect for the French team. But, well, you'll have to go some to beat the CV of this man. Here is Vincent Hancock of the United States strolling onto the field. The three times Olympic gold medalist, four times world champion. What an athlete he has been. And what really an advert for this sport. Two relays, two squads, remember? This is Luigi Lodda. Three Italians in with a chance to make it onto the podium. Can you imagine what the crowd here would be feeling if they all made it? This is the 42-year-old, of course. His birthday last week. Fifth at the Olympic Games in London. Has a World Cup final gold, a World Cup gold two times over, and a couple of times European champion. Germany, well, they got themselves a bronze medal with Messerschmitt in the women's competition. They have a chance with Vincent Hager, the 26-year-old. World Championship silver in Moscow 5 years ago. Jesper Hansen of Denmark, also in that second squad, Olympic silver medalist in Tokyo, you may remember. Fifth in Rio, world champion way back in 2013. Real quality athlete. We've got four Olympic gold medalists, by the way, in our ranks. Rossetti one time, Hancock three time. And here's a man who, well, I think it's fair to say, would aspire to that. The 25-year-old from Cyprus, Stefanos Nicolaidis, the junior world championship silver medalist in 2014. Not much in the trophy cabinet since then, but a real chance to change that today. So eight finalists, four different athletes in each squad. Keith Shields is the man who is our jury member in charge. Marian Carbonaru is our referee, a man from Romania who's been busy this afternoon refereeing the women's competition as well.
So now squad two, please be back. And let's start with squad one.
So our first squad, Hancock, Lejeune, Struccioli, Rossetti, a couple of Italians, so a real chance for a double success. My Italian TV contacts and then away to my right, certainly interested in this one, commentating for national broadcaster. We are underway with the three-time Olympic gold medalist, Vincent Hancock, the man from the Fort Worth Trap and Skeet Club. The man likes golf. Likes to be on a different range from time to time. Oh, and a miss. A miss just goes to prove we're all human. 24 golds to his name. I wonder if he's going to make it a quarter of a century here today. Certainly topped qualification. 125. Luigi Lode of Italy, also 125, a perfect 125. They went to a shoot-off. It was Hancock after six targets. For third and fourth, Lejeune and Harder. And here's Lejeune. He came second best to Lode, which is why he's in this squad. It went to Harger, rather. It went to 23 targets. And then, for 6, 7, 8, we had a eight-way shoot-off for those three places. Hansen, Rossetti, Nikolaidis. It went to 20 shots for Hansen to take sixth, and Nikolaidis, well, nine shots for him to take the eighth place. So a lot of shoot-offs. It took a while to sort out who was going to be in the final. We got there eventually. Good from Lejeune, not so good, perhaps, from Struccioli. Here's the 27-year-old, 14 golds to his name.
Oh.
And is that a miss? As it is as well. So only Lejeune, the Frenchman, getting through at the moment unscathed to the second station. This station number four, a reminder of how it works. 20 targets before our first athlete leaves. So it's station three, station four, station five. Twice, and that's 20 targets. We lose our first athlete. Another 10 targets, so once around the three shooting positions, and our second athlete leaves, and we have two left for the medal match. And any ties, pip number, which is of course determined by qualification, which is why the shoot-offs are so important. Well, if you've got the lower pip, you'll stay in. One red from that station, that's Rossetti. Andrea Benelli, and the Italian coach. Fabio Partigiani is the other Italian coach for Struccioli. It's a nice problem to have. Too many athletes, not enough coaches in finals. To station five we are. And this is a reverse, a mirror image of station number three. Hancock. A picture of concentration. Rossetti loitering. Just keeping himself in the zone. Good from Hancock. Lejeune. Youngest alongside Struccioli at 23 in this first semi-final. And Arambulu watching on carefully. Both the Frenchman and the American are shooting well. Struccioli crouched over the shotgun. It's very interesting to see the different stances these athletes take. Some are a little ball of energy, some trying to be a bit more, well, I guess laid back's not the word. Took a while on that one out the low house and paid the price. There's the other Italian coach.
Oh.
Rossetti needs these two to stay in touch, the two Italians, third and fourth at the moment. Oh, please the local aficionados, but they like that. And it can all change. We'll go back round to station number three. That's how it was. Not a lot of change as we head towards these next 10 targets that will determine the first athlete to leave. And Hancock with that very valuable number one on the back of his bib. Good, doesn't he? And you just, I was wondering beforehand, does he get nervous? Does he get a little bit wound up? I mean, you've had three Olympic golds to your name. Is this just a little early evening stroll in the park? Do you have to G yourself up a wee bit? Well, he's a class act. He enjoys his sport, does Vincent Hancock. Still only 33 years of age. I mean, that's the scary thing, isn't it, really? Miss from Lejeune. Which brings him back into the orbit of Hancock.
Oh. Next up.
Concentration behind those glasses, and did he get a little nibble? He did not, and no challenge from the Italian coaches.
Oh!
Shot quickly, shot effectively, Rossetti. He's only 27 years of age as well. Already a gold medalist at the Olympics, a world champion. European Games gold, a European Championship to his name. And they like him here in Lenato, that's for sure. You can hear the response to his bagging four greens on that last station. Now to station four. Just the two, of course, out of the low house first.
Four.
No problem for the man in the shorts. Now Lejeune of France from the Breville Club. There's our French contingent, or at least some of them. There's the official French contingent. Ruccioli now. Oh, and the hand goes up straight away, and then rather belatedly so does Andrea Benelli's hand with the VAR card. He felt he hit that one. So we'll have the official review of the officials heading towards their screen just to make sure they can see what we can see. Hopefully we'll get a little look as well. You can be your own judge and jury. We saw a couple of occasions in the women's competition where a decision was overturned. It's a little bit coming out. Can you see anything here at the moment? I would have to say no, but I am not the man and the woman tasked with deciding this. A It's a good bit of work from our camera operators. I don't think there's going to be a good result here for the athletes. No. Thumbs down from our Romanian referee. Struccioli has to put up with it. And Gabriele Rossetti, his fellow Italian, has had to wait a while for the chance to get his two shots away from session number four.
Oh.
Well, that's better for Italy. But they're still bottom of the pile. And running out of targets before somebody leaves. So Rossetti ahead of Struccioli now. And he's not far away from Hancock and Lejeune.
Four.
Excellent. Very positive from Hancock.
Four.
Hunger unabated. I mean, when is enough enough? Well, there is a miss. Lejeune with a chance to take the lead.
Four.
Just disappearing past us to get more cartridges for the next stage of this competition. He will be hoping, perhaps expecting, oh, there is a miss, to get into the last two battle. A glug of water as he walks back.
Oh.
And then Struccioli needs to give it his all here. And, well, it's out of his hands. Apart from this bit.
Oh.
So that's good stuff. But Rossetti needs three. And if he ties with Struccioli, Struccioli has a better bib number. These will do the job.
Oh.
Well, two will do the job even better. And it means the top three are all level. But one has to leave. And that is the youngster, the 23-year-old, who started pretty strongly. The man who won the gold in Nicosia can't continue his rich vein of form. He will take fourth place in this first squad. So three left, all on 18. Another 10 targets. Go round one more time before we realise who will be the two to go forward to the medal match. Rossetti is just making, you can see there he is, making his way round. Not in a particular hurry. Just had a sip of water. Put some more cartridge in your pocket. They can all wait, I think he's thinking. So then, Hancock, Lejeune, Rossetti, all on 18. 10 more targets. Who will fall by the wayside? Remember, it is the Italian who has the disadvantage in terms of bib number. So he needs as many greens as he can and hope somebody else just falls a bit short.
Four.
Really pleasant evening here. The temperature. My Italian colleague away to my right is still wearing, I would say, four layers. I don't quite see it. We are in the shade. But it's lovely, lovely temperature. Still just about in the 20s. Good start from Hancock. Good start from Lejeune. The French are enjoying what their compatriot is doing. Man from Saint-Cyran inside the world top 20. Rossetti. We'll never forget them. That moment in Rio, winning the gold. It was a fabulous day, a fabulous final. A great first go around to station three. Now to four. Just the one double. Really don't want to make a mistake here. All on 22. Very finely poised. Rossetti, by dint of his higher bib number, will be the one to go if it carries on like this. Hancock wanders away. Good for Lejeune. Now Rossetti, the Italians here will be holding their breath, hoping for the best. And they like what they see. Andrea Benelli likes what he sees. That's how it looks, all on 24. The American has his four from station five. Real pressure on these athletes now, it's so tight.
Four.
Who will take their place with Hancock? He is assured the medal match. Even if it's all tied because of his lowest bib number. Number one. Oh, there is a miss from Lejeune. And lifeline perhaps for Rossetti. Needs to be ahead numerically. You can just see the way he walks away. It's not all over. He has to get all four here, Rossetti. Lejeune. The way he walked away, you could just tell his disappointment. But he needs these two, Rossetti, and if he does, he'll leapfrog Lejeune and he will take his place in the medal match alongside Hancock. Lejeune could hardly bear to watch. And he hits both. Listen to the response. Excellent from the Italian, who kept going. His compatriot might have been the first to leave, but he books his place in the medal match. Lejeune, well, not to be for the youngster. And so Italy do have somebody in the final, and it is Gabriele Rossetti, the Olympic champion from Rio. Second place for him, Vincent Hancock, cruising through again. And they will go and take their place away from the finals arena, Hancock and Rossetti, and get themselves ready for their next challenge, whilst our next four look to join them. So it is another Italian opportunity. We said we had three in the finals, the two semi-finals, so to speak. Lode, the 42-year-old, Hager of Germany, Hansen of Denmark, Nicolaides of Cyprus, two in their 20s, two just in their 40s. And that's why I was saying Hancock, what he's achieved, still only 33 years of age. We are ready to get underway. Remember, first 20 targets, two times around this three shooting positions. And we will lose our first athlete, and then another 10, and we will know who is the two athletes to make it through to the medal match. It will be a high quality medal match, already four Olympic golds in total in the two athletes who are through.
Oh.
Lode, fifth in London, his best Olympic effort, but never say never, certainly within his grasp to come to the party in Paris. This is Vincent Hager, the 26-year-old. The most notable achievement, that World Championship silver in Moscow. Ooh, and that is a miss from the low house. A little look from the athlete to the coach, not challenged. Hansen, the 41-year-old. Another medalist, this time a silver from Tokyo. Strange old Olympic Games, really, with the COVID restrictions, and in the history books, no one will see that. It'll just be what medal you got, and you'll be delighted with that. A real chance to continue his good run. And here's Nicolaides, the 25-year-old junior world championship silver. That now, 8 years ago. The hand goes up from our Romanian referee. So Hager and Nicolaides with three, Lolli and Hansen with four. Early days, of course.
Oh.
Back to the Italian. Stands of four. We've got a decent amount of people watching from behind the stand. Well, not behind the stand, you won't see anything, but you know what I mean, behind the arena. Got a lovely hedge behind us where we're sitting, but a lot of people stood behind that watching. They have a big screen to help them as well, and the scoreboard as well. Hansen. Very distinctive call. Now Nicolaides, from what should be an easier, not always so, station four. See, shouldn't have said it, should I? Missed the one from the low house. So that is a second miss for him. And Hager will be happy to see that on the scoreboard, I'm sure. Station 5, of course, so the reverse, the mirror image of station 3, so they start low and high, and then it's high followed by low in the reverse, so exactly the opposite of what they have to shoot the other side. Well, the Italians like that. Will they get two into the final? They're at least then guaranteed a medal, because there's only four in the medal match. So far, so good for all these athletes. The German Hager, looking good. The man from Heringsdorf. Remember Nadine Messerschmidt with a bronze medal for Germany in the women's competition. Silver for Amber Hill of Great Britain, and a gold for Caitlin Connor of the United States. I made that her first gold after seven silvers. But I think she's a world champion from the past as well. It's not as if she's never really been on the top step of the podium. Hansen with a miss. Nikolaidis needs to not miss, really. He's already adrift slightly. Yep, bravo, the call from the crowd. Absolutely right, nicely done. Keeps himself within one of Hansen and Hager. Hansen with that one miss, just dropping him down by dint of being a lower bib number. Remember, the bib numbers will decide if we are tied at the end of 20 and at the end of 30 targets.
Oh.
Andrea Benelli
oh.
in the first semi-final when we had a couple of Italian athletes. His athlete Rossetti got through, hoping for the same here. Lode, great start, looking good at the moment. Perhaps rather snatched it. I've been shooting both targets close together is a good sign. That just felt a little bit snatched. So Hager drops the target. Hansen. No problem at all, marches off to collect his thoughts and his water bottle. Nikolaidis, will he be an outlier here? He is struggling to keep with the rest, but he has a chance to go level with Hager. Again, Hager will have the advantage on bib number. Oh, he's looking good, isn't he? Finished qualification after that epic shoot-off. Eight athletes for three places. He was the last one to secure, well, I suppose the first one to secure a place because he dropped down after nine shots. Rossetti after 19, Hansen after 20. You have to feel for people like Opinix of Latvia, Mitas of Greece, Michalides of Cyprus. Got all the way to that eight-person shoot-off and missed the first one. That's a lot of a letdown, isn't it? Pumping yourself up to get into the shoot-off and exiting pretty soon. It happens, you've got to accept it. So far, so good for everybody. We said this last time, then Nikolaidis missed the second in this middle station. Not this time. And he's got his support in the stands. Lode, the Italian, one ahead of Hansen. Hager and Nikolaidis on 14. We will lose our first athlete here at this session number five after 20 targets. One miss for Lode. Does not want to have another one here.
Oh.
Ah. Oh, and a miss there from Hager. So a double miss from Lodder and a miss from Hager. Right, Hansen with a chance to go into the lead here. Nikolaidis with a chance after that miss from Hager to stay in this competition. Just goes to prove just one miss can be so important, but it's... Oh! And a miss from Hansen as well. Well, has to be all four for Nikolaidis. Hansen's just gone marching off. Get some more ammunition just to forget about that last target. So, how important is this? Two chances to stay in this competition. Hager will be ruining that last miss. He's been really good in form. Oh, he misses the last one. And the card goes up for VAR. More in hope than expectation. I think it dipped a little bit. It wasn't a nice trajectory. Oh, dear. It's 17 apiece for Hager and Nikolaidis. But Nikolaidis has the lower bib number. Bib number's 8. Hager with bib number 4 from qualification. We're going to have a look. I don't think we're going to see anything, but I've been proved wrong many times before, as you know. Well, the jury member, Keith Shields, a Romanian referee, a German VAR official, all looking through this. That's a good shot, isn't it? And I can't see anything that's come off that target. It's an important call. And yeah, it goes down the thumb and down goes the opportunity to stay in this competition for the Cypriot Stefanos Nikolaidis. I have a feeling we might see him again in the finals. He didn't shoot well initially and then really got into the groove and you just thought, well, you can see how many greens there were right until the last minute. But it is fine margins, of course. Now another 10 targets and we will see who misses out on the chance to take a medal in the medal match. 4 athletes, of course, 2 from the first series, 2 from this series. Lodder and Hansen with a point advantages over the German, Hager. They were waiting for Lodde. I wonder what the delay was. Being hurried on by Keith Shields. He's on his way. He's not jogging. I suppose he's not shuffling either. And it's Lodde who will get us underway as well. So we really did have to wait for him. He's not being given a card or being chastised by the referee, I don't think. 10 more targets, then one more go around these 3 shooting positions.
Oh.
Great camera position over the shoulder of the Italian, just shows how quickly they get these shots away.
Oh.
No, a miss. Again, this time not on that final one. It was the one coming out of the low house. So, you know, a red here, a red there. It could all change. Certainly, Hager will be telling that to himself. He gives the cartridge out of the way, feet planted. Get himself ready. Oh, and I think that was a miss. Yes, it was. Well, that was the one out of the high house. Just gone 6 o'clock local time. The shadows lengthening. Luckily, the sun over the shoulder, as you would expect on a well-designed range. Took his time on the second, not a problem. A bit quicker between the two that time. Four greens. So Hansen finds himself in the lead. Lode dropping down into second, and Hager within a point of the Italian, who will get us underway from position number four, the middle one. Just the one double here for these two these athletes, and three athletes to attempt. Done. The German just finding a wee bit of form. Now Hansen, the 41-year-old. Still got it, hasn't he? Still looking good. Calm as a cucumber. Cool as a cucumber. But he's quite relaxed anyway. Certainly to those of us watching from afar. And he has put himself in with a great chance here of going through. He has the lower bib number, but if he keeps hitting, he'll be all right. Now Lodder, two here, and he is guaranteed to go through. And took his time on that second one. He's pumped up, isn't he? Pumped up. So is the crowd. Two Italians in the medal match. He's these two, Hager. And he gets them as well. So Hansen has a lower bib number, or higher bib number, eight, but lower in terms of pecking order. So he needs one of these to go through and to consign Hager to third place in the second semi-final. Well, he doesn't bother with one, he'll bother with two and goes top, and that's important in terms of bib number for the medal match as well. It is Vincent Hager who has to settle for third place and misses out. The 26-year-old will have to wait for another day for a medal. Lodder just walking past me here, didn't a little wry smile. I don't think he was particularly pleased with his performance, but it's enough to get him through. Hansen and Lodder then we'll go through and take on Hancock and Rossetti, the four athletes who make it through to the medal match. And that is what is coming up in a few minutes' time.
So, ladies and gentlemen, the organizing committee of the ISSF World Cup Leonardo 2022 and the International Shooting Sport Federation welcome you in the sunny Italy at the beautiful shooting range Trap Concobere for the medal match in Skip Man event. It's our honor to host this final today, and we have also here our mascot Peyton to say hi to our athletes. So let's welcome them. Our position number four.
Clayton, come in, only one thing. We're about to get underway in the men's skeet medal match. Four athletes after three medals. We have some astonishingly accomplished athletes. It's a high quality field. Luigi Lode, first to be introduced to the crowd. Two Italians, of course, in this last stage of this final. The 42-year-old had his birthday last week. We'll be hoping for a late birthday present. Jesper Hansen coming in after Gabriele Rossetti, the Olympic gold medalist from Rio, of course, the Italian. Hansen, Olympic silver in Tokyo last year. The 41-year-old, also a former world champion. But none has a CV like Vincent Hancock, the three times Olympic gold medalist, 14 World Cup golds. Four world championships, 24 golds in total. Ran from the Fort Worth Trap and Skeet Club in a category of his own. Keith Shields is our jury member in charge. And our referee has had a busy afternoon. The man from Romania, Marian Carbonaru, has made his Italian host smile with the closeness of his name to a particular Italian dish. To be fair, he's smiling as well. There's the final four then. Hancock, Hansen, Rossetti and Lodi. A reminder of how it is going to work. We will see these athletes shoot 20 targets, then fourth place is decided. 10 targets after that, bronze will be decided, that's 30 in total. Then another 10 targets. Whoa. Before we know who will take gold and silver. Joe Waldron, very happy with the women's competition. Gold for Caitlin Connor. Will it be double dibs? Whoa. For the Americans? Hansen, cool, calm, collected. Couple of, a World Cup gold last year in New Delhi. Three silvers, two bronzes, and that's for silver at Tokyo. Now the two Italians. Oh, no one's moved. We're getting more people behind us, watching from behind the hedge. I say behind the hedge, it's only a small hedge. It's not as if you have to sort of crane or get a ladder. No misses so far in this final.
Oh.
No commentator's curse for Rossetti. Four greens for him. Oh, that man who's been in an Olympic final, didn't get a medal in London. A couple of World Cup golds for him in his career. I'd like to make it a hat trick, I am sure.
Oh,
miss. And it's the athlete who put his hand up straight away, and a little look across from Andrea Benelli. And we have our first VAR of the final.
No ball. Good. Gave it to him. No ball. Okay.
No, it's been given as a green. So we are all ready and set. to station 4. 3, 4 and 5 used in finals. Jim Waldron, no reason to be at all anxious at this point. Athletes struggle with this normally straightforward station. Don't know whether that's the conditions. But he's just starting to waft from right to left. Nothing to write home about, though, to be honest with you. Five, where if you were with us earlier, we were talking about the fact it's a mirror image, a reverse of station 3. Not a problem for Hancock. Takes his water from his coach, retreats, lets the others do their business. Two Italians lagging behind at the moment. Not the storybook final so far for the home fans. Sitting on the concrete bleachers. But, well, Hansen with a miss. And Rossi and Lodder have a chance to overhaul him here.
Oh.
Nicely done. Now then, can we warm the hearts of the Italian fans here by getting these two, putting himself in a strong position.
Oh.
Took his time on the second one. 10 for him. Hansen with just the one miss, the first miss of this final. Lodde. We're looking to do the same. I mean, I'm going to have to keep the scoring going well because Rossetti has bib number 3, Lodi bib number 4. And it will be a shoot-off if they're tied to gold and silver, but before that it does go on bib numbers. A little fist bump, a little look towards the coach. Fabio Partigiani is the coach. For him, and of course Andrea Benelli for Rossetti. Ready. Once more round, and we will know who's going to be on the podium and who has missed out. Hansen. A disadvantage, just a slight pause there. Hancock in conversation with the referee.
Four.
No difference to the outcome.
Four.
Did well, didn't let that second one go too far down away from him. That's the problem some athletes find themselves in. Hansen needs to keep the mistakes to a minimum. He is at one target disadvantage.
Ow.
Almost feel the tension when the Italians are at the range. Everyone around just a little tenser, hoping for the best outcome possible. Ooh, and that wasn't a good outcome. So a miss from Rossetti on that reverse, the one coming out of the high house.
Oh.
And he moves away. I think there was, a target. Didn't come out of the high house. There's a puff of smoke coming out of the high house. And Lotte just walking away, letting the officials get on with what they have to do to make sure. You can see the referee just needs another one to come out here. And so, Lotte to my left, a bit of frantic on the controls to make sure they can fly one out. Yeah, it's all okay. They've just let one go from the high and the low house. It all seems to be working again. Not easy for these athletes.
Oh.
It is what they have to deal with, though. Keith Shields going over.
Oh.
To have a conversation and they're just double checking. That's the second time, and they are happy. And we are to get underway with the competition again. Just a slight technical hitch from the high house.
Oh.
A long wait for the Italian. Not a problem for him at all, though.
Oh.
And that puts him level with Hancock. And as we go around to the next position, position four, the double here with no reverse. That delay perhaps just adding to the tension a little bit.
Four.
Hand goes up again, pointing at the microphone this time. Well, we've had a faultless technical World Cup, really, generally. No, he just said it's working. You can hear him say it's working. Steps onto the shooting position. The 30 seconds counts down on the clock away to his right.
Four.
No problem whatsoever. Jay Waldron like that, the coach. Big round of applause from him. Little whoop of delight. Hansen, slightly more circumspect. He and his coach equally efficient as well. Remember, go round to station five and we will confirm our fourth place athlete. So the medals, the podium. We all know the three athletes, but not what colour the medals will be for them. Big cheer from the crowd for Rossetti. Now Lode as well with a chance to join Hancock on 16. Not a problem. It's still really tight though, isn't it? Remember, if it's level after these four targets for each athlete, then the one with the lower bib number will have to make way. We'll keep you up to date with that. Hancock 1, Hansen 2, Rossetti 3, Lodi 4 in terms of the bib number. Oh. Well, Hancock is... he was perfect, wasn't he, in qualification. He's not been bad in this final here. Oh, commentator's curse. What was I thinking? Well, he'll go through. not a problem because he has the top bib, but he is not happy. He's stalking past me here. Chance for Hansen to join him on 19. And that will consign Rossetti unless Lottie has a... Oh, shocker. Hold that thought. Miss from Hansen. Oh, now then. From expecting an Italian to go out, it could be the Dane who goes. Four needed from Zetti, and he will need all four.
Oh.
Well, there's the cheer from the crowd that tells you he has really done very well. So Hansen on 18, Lodi on 16.
Oh.
He's going to need 19. Needs one of these two. Surely he can get through. And you just listen to the Italian response if he does.
Oh.
Gets both of them. And his coach is on his feet. And what a response from the crowd. Oh, you've got to feel for Hansen. And it was the last shot. It looked like he was going to cruise through. But he misses out and he walks away talking to himself, remonstrating with himself. You can sit by the coach if you want to. I think he's going to take a bit of time just to compose himself. Others heading off in the same direction, but to get more cartridges. That is our podium. But who is going to be on top of it? Hancock, well, was cruising nicely. Missed that last one. And so, only one with a perfect 20, and that is Luigi Lodi. We await the re-emergence. I think, who is, are we waiting for? One of the Italians. It's Lodi, who's getting some more cartridges. They basically come with their cartridges. They are sealed by the officials. They're not allowed to mess with them after that once they've been approved. They do weigh the cartridges randomly to make sure they're all standard. There's a certain weight, no more, no less. They go into the office where the officials are. They have these perhaps drinks, water containers full of lead shot, and it's actually a lot heavier than it looks. You try and pick it up, it's quite difficult, and that's from all the measuring that they do. Right, here we go then, heading towards 7 o'clock local time in the evening. The shadows are very long, might be a bit tricky from station number 5. Shouldn't be so much of a problem from here because you've got the sun on your back. Another 10 targets, we'll know who takes bronze. Can Hancock upset the Italians? The two heavyweight nations really of shotgun. Never a problem for the triple gold Olympic medalists. Hancock with one. Rossetti with that gold in Rio.
Oh.
Dominating the last four Olympic Games between them. Well, their age suggests that they'll be hard to displace. Hancock at 33, Rossetti at 27. We've seen some youngsters though. Nicolaidis at 25. Struccioli at 23. Ooh. Rossetti with a miss. Groom from the crowd. Yeah, it's just getting a little low in the sky, the sun now. But at least we have the sun. It was dark. One of our finals days in Trap. The scoreboard was beaming out like a lighthouse at one point. I suppose the conditions are the same for everybody. They have their light-enhancing glasses. That pleases the Italians. Lode still with a point lead. As we head around to station number 4. Looks so businesslike, doesn't he? As if it really isn't a stretch at all. You're not in a final of a World Cup. Oh no.
Oh.
I guess the pressure is really on the Italians. You know there's a big crowd cheering every move. Lode as well gets a cheer from the crowd. If they can see, with the sun, as you can see, low in the sky, they'll be happy. Rossetti at the disadvantage at the moment as we go round to this station that will decide the bronze medal.
Four.
That's a great start. Again, he's busy, isn't he, around the shooting position. Hancock doesn't hang around.
Four.
Excellent from Vincent Hancock. So he will definitely be in that gold medal shoot-off. Off and away. Get some more cartridges he goes. Not bothering to see who he'll be taking on. Well, Rossetti needs both of these. And then to sit back and see.
Oh.
Nicely done. 28 for him. Lode has the lower bib number 4. So he needs, this is from the two semi-finals, of course, not from qualification. So he needs to hit one of these two. A tie is not good enough for him. President of the Italian Shooting Federation watching on.
Oh.
Both will do. And Lone, another little fist pump. A little handshake of congratulations for Rossetti, who is confirmed in the bronze medal position. So Gabriele Rossetti, the former Olympic champion, unable to get onto the top step of this podium. Unable to add to his 14 career golds, but another bronze medal at the home, his home of shooting, Italian Mecca, so to speak. Here in Lenato, so you can sit in the sunshine and enjoy the conversation with his coach. And the next 10 targets, we'll get to 40, we'll know who takes gold and silver. If it's tied, we go to a shoot-off.
Four.
The sun is very low in the sky now, the coach is having to try and block it out to see what's going on. What they're seeing is another good start from Hancock.
Four.
He's looking in good nick, isn't he? But Lode, it's in his hands at the moment.
Oh.
He if willpower could power an athlete, this Italian would bruise it.
Oh.
And it's all up to him. The crowd can't help, really. He is very pumped up, isn't he? He's one of those who shows his emotion. Hancock. By his standards, a spot of bother, I guess. One behind. But still, these athletes have six targets each. Two from here, four from station number five. And a miss from Hancock. Well, well, well. You don't see him in this situation very often. Is it not going to be an American one?
Oh.
I was going to say a 1-2, but double gold. I think it's perhaps the best way to describe it. I don't think so at this rate. A double from Lodde. 2-point the advantage. Four targets to come from station five. Well, everyone here, bar the American contingent and perhaps a few neutrals, will be leaning towards the emotion of an Italian gold medal here. Hancock's job, put some pressure on Lodde. Luigi Lodde, not easily intimidated though, hey? Nicely done from Hancock. Just the two misses, but a chance for Lodde to go through this perfectly. A little wry smile from Vincent Hancock. He shot well, but will it be good enough? One needed. Oh, it's all getting a little bit excitable behind me. Well, 40 out of 40 would be some way to beat three-time Olympic champion, wouldn't it? How about that? How about that? Luigi Lodde. Fabulous scenes here at Lenato as the Italian manages to beat Vincent Hancock in a fabulous display of shooting. Congratulated generously by Hancock, and then Rossetti able to come and give his congratulations to his fellow Italian. What a fabulous final that was. What composure and what skill. And what drama. Now the Italians could only manage fourth in the women's final. They've managed the gold and the bronze here. In the dying embers of the sunshine here in Lenato, there is a very bright moment for Italian shooting. Those are our three confirmation. Italy and Gabriele Rossetti take the bronze. The United States, Vincent Hancock, takes the silver. But a perfect display really in this final. Luigi Lodde of Italy takes the gold in front of the home fans.
Finally together, now I need you. Sì, lo sento solo un po'. Io prendo me ne vado. Quello da 14.